Yeah, it was good. It's Mainbox and Pica. Enjoying a beautiful ride. Man, I enjoyed the fights we saw last night. Saw some beautiful fights. Man, hey, shout out to Derek Chisora, man. He brought war to that fight. I mean, Derek Chisora suffered from stamina issues. Derek Chisora might need to try a vegan diet to kind of like get phlegm out of his system. He might want to go on an alkaline diet or something to reduce the mucus, because I think that's what be getting to him. I mean, from round two or three, you look at this man in the corner and Derek Chisora is hacking up shit, tooting, spitting, going crazy, gasping for air the whole fight. The man, like, the corner talking to him, he can't even respond. He's so gassed out by round two, bruh. Now, it could be due to him throwing those haymakers too. No pun intended. Trainer is David Hay, and he throwing haymakers. Or is that his manager? Whatever he is, I don't know. But I mean, he got to stop winging them wide shots. But shout out to him, because them wide shots was clubbing the hell out of Joseph Parker too. Joseph Parker looked terrible out there, man. He was getting hit with haymakers, got dropped in the first round savagely. I always hate this turn. There'd be oil on the road. You can't even like lean the bike the way you want to. Yeah. But I mean, Derek Chisora just pretty much, he be defeating himself because he gets so damn tired. But the man got a hell of a chin on him. But I think Joseph Parker was either tired or intimidated also. Because there's times when Joseph Parker had the man Derek Chisora on the ropes, hurt, and he won't go in for the kill. He just won't go in for the kill. I don't get it. It's like he'll go in and Derek Chisora will just throw one of them push jabs. No snapping the jab. He's not snapping the bitch at the end. He's just throwing the joint regular. And then Joseph Parker had no answer for it. It's like, and Joseph Parker had the longer reach. He was the taller man. I thought he was going to be just out jabbing and 1-2-ing Derek Chisora from the outside, but he didn't. So with that being said, you know, they went to decision. I'm going to be honest. Derek Chisora did better than they're giving him credit for. That's just what I saw. I think that fight could have been edged a little bit to Derek Chisora, or I would have been contented with a draw. But I don't. Parker didn't do what he didn't do enough. That's just what I'm gonna say. He didn't do enough. He didn't do enough to win that fight. So I gotta give that fight to I gotta say that fight wasn't. It didn't play out the way I wanted it to play out. That wasn't right. Derek Chisora, he stayed getting screwed over. I ain't gonna say it's no high, you know, high-end robbery or nothing. It ain't no high-end robbery, but it is a slight robbery, because I saw Derek Chisora do enough to at least edge out that fight by 1 point, or to get a draw. But whatever. I guess Derek Chisora needs to figure out what he's gonna retire, or get on a serious, serious, serious diet. He needs to get on a serious diet. Mucus is what's causing him his problem. You can hear it. He's gasping. He's hacking up mucus. He's spitting out clumps of mucus in the corner. He needs to alkalinize his body. But this ain't no health type of video right now. But that's just something that I noticed. He needs to get rid of the mucus in his body, and it'll increase his breathing. Second off, next, the Fundura fight. I think Fundura, I'm just reviewing fights randomly. Matter of fact, let's go to Lara. Lara, man, holy smokes. That was a vicious knockout. Shout out to Erislandy Lara, man. He knocked that boy out. Ooh. Lara stepped up in weight, and he showed he can still compete, and I'm happy with what I saw. Thank you, ambulance, for letting me get over. Yeah, but it shows that he can still compete with these boys. So shout out to Lara for that. Sensational knockout. Cota versus Fundura. Fundura just, it was too much, man. He was too much. Granted, Cota did hurt him a couple of times. But Fundura, man, he just swarms you. I don't understand, dude. 6'6 and 100. Man, how does he do it? I don't know how he does it 154 at 6'6. Boy, I'm 5'11 and I weigh more than boy. I'm 164, 165-ish. So shout out to Fandora. I don't know how he does it, but hey, shout out to homeboy. And he can scrap. And he can scrap on the inside. That's why he's gonna be a problem. Because a lot of dudes that's that tall, the shorter opponents be like, alright, get on the inside and swarm him. This motherfucker can swarm on the inside too. So I don't know what to tell him. How to keep this man off of them, but it's gonna be a hell of a fight to keep this man off of you, man. We gotta see what he looked like against some tougher competitions though. So we'll see. We got the Parker versus not Parker. We got the main event, Ruiz. Andy, the Destroyer, Ruiz versus Chris Arreola. Now, Chris Arreola put up a good fight. He made a good name for himself last night. Granted, he already had a good name, but Chris Arreola showed us a lot last night. I'm happy with what he did. He came in, he dropped the man early in the fight. He did what he had to do. I believe he did put up a good fight. He did lose the fight, but I mean, granted, he claimed it's a shoulder. I mean, it's not like you threw out the shoulder, punching with the shoulder. You threw out the shoulder, kind of like getting hit right in the upper, that nice little sensitive spot in the upper shoulder that we like to get massaged on and shit like that. Not the delts, but the other one. Yeah, not your traps. I mean, I guess, right, yeah, whatever. But right there. And it caused him a problem, and he couldn't throw that left like that no more. He started pawing with the left, started walking in with like a kind of like a pushing jab instead of snapping a jab. His little sweeping left hook, he ain't had it no more. But guess what? He did land a lot of vicious shots on Andy Ruiz. He was beating the crap out of Andy Ruiz. I felt like he should have pushed the issue early in the game on Andy Ruiz, and I think it would have helped a lot. He didn't push the issue. I think if he pushed the issue, he could have been able to get him out of there. Maybe in that second round when he had Andy Ruiz on the floor and hurt. Andy Ruiz looked a little wobble-legged when he got up. He still had the spaghetti legs. At that point, he should have jumped on him and, you know, get him up out of there. But he didn't. So, at that point, I don't know what to say. I mean, I don't know where Chris Arreola should go from now on, from here on. He said he wanted a rematch. I mean, granted, maybe he should. Maybe he should take a rematch. And let's see how it go. You know, maybe this time he'll realize, damn, don't play with your food when you got your food right there in front of you. You know? But, hey, that's all I got. It's Main Boxing Biker. I'll holler at y'all later. Peace.